You have that familiar understanding. However, you know, the honeymoon phase is a powerful tool in Rocket League. We've seen a bunch of teams at the top level when they get new players, they come out and they pop off for a tournament. So who knows?
Well, see, CRL, real quick, what would you rather have? You rather have the new squad mystique, the honeymoon phase, or more experience?
I would love to have more experience personally and build upon a roster that I already have.
All right, let's see if Maryland Red's gonna be able to carry that forward into the bracket, or will the newcomers or the new roster of Drexel University pull forward? Gentlemen, let's jump in.
That's also why Corelli got kicked off his team, because they liked the roster they already had.
We're all having a good time here at the desk, aren't we, Corelli?
All of us but one.
Here comes Maryland Red with some early pressure. Dabin wants the top of the net. He will find it. And the Terps on the board first.
Yeah, this is what you got to look out for. Miles and Dabin linking up here on the far or off the backboard. Excuse me. This is a fantastic shot from Dabin just under the crossbar. And for Chase, you look back on that one, you feel like he's got to make the connection there on the back wall. He doesn't and lets Dabin come through for Maryland. Puts him up 1-0.
You got to think there's some warming up to do on the side of Drexel. You got Scapegoat backing up into the ball while your other two teammates are in the net.
Oh, my goodness.
Not the best defensive positioning, I'd say.
Not the best defensive positioning, but they did generate some early offensive pressure before that goal went in. Actually, that one just floats in, and I have no clue what happened on the line.
I think there was a flying taco across the net there, and I think Miles got a little tangled up there as he saw Taco come through across. Either way, a little mix-up in communication there for Maryland, and Drexel get a freebie as that one's just thrown towards the net, and it walks in.
You gotta wonder if Maryland Red is gonna be able to throw that one out the window and be like, guys, whatever. That's just one goal, a lot more Rocket League to play, or if that's going to be a tilting trendsetter over the course of the series, very important moment here for Maryland Red.
So 16 seconds for the Dragons to find the equalizer here in game one. And looking to pick up right where they left off. Dabin is almost able to get that one around Chase. Straight off the sidewall, free ball for Taco. He's rocking the Scarab, man. I don't remember the last time we saw a Scarab.
Well, I believe the first few times we saw Taco, he was rocking the Jaeger.
He does like his oddball card, you know?
He's a man of culture.
Next thing you know, he's going to be driving the Merc and giving James Bond a nod, and we can't have that. But currently, the Dragons applying some pressure. Miles actually had some time there again.
A flying taco again.
A flying taco again, and disaster strikes twice. Lightning may not strike in the same place. Tacos do.
Yeah, and that one's unfortunate. You can see Miles a little greedy with the control there, as I believe he was going up for an air dribble there. He could have easily just brought that ball down and forced the 1v1 on the flick, but instead gets rammed by his teammate Taco. An unfortunate situation, and just small mistakes coming out from Maryland right now. Drexel there to take advantage.
I love that we had that camera angle Scapegoat too, because like you could see the entire thought process. Okay. I was going to say, you can see how he's going to back away. He's already, they're going to clear. Oh, wait, they're going to leave it wide open? Okay. But now when Chain wants to get involved, too.
Oh, the hesitation. Taco was headed up the back wall, chose not to do it, and then just caught the rebound and slammed it home.
Yeah, and Miles thought that Taco was going to go for it, so he stopped and went back into, or stopped inside of his net. Now a 3-1 lead for Drexel as they've kind of stunned this Maryland squad.
Good news is they have plenty of time to stop the bleeding and get going back the other way. But they got to get command of the ball first, and that might come through Dabin. However, Unchain, other thoughts, and once more into the Terps' corner. Bumped around in the midfield. Taco gets one put to him from Dabin. Not enough power on the ball, though. The Dragons to delay. Chase, soft ball off the back wall. Miles to control and make it another one. Unchain a little bit too aggressive. Scapegoat right at the top of the box, and it's a wide open net. Miles can't pick it up and make the lead 3 for the Dragons.
And this goal comes off of a lot of pressure coming off the back wall, but it's a very, very weak and poor place clear from David. That third man is always ready for any ball that comes centrally in front of the box. They will always be there to at least force the challenge. This time it was a free shot on net. And Maryland have really struggled on defense. Lots of mistakes coming out. And kudos to Drexel to capitalize and put the ball away.
I said after goal number one, Maryland Red, it's an important moment. Either you tilt or you just shrug it off and get back to playing the game.
Oh.
It just feels like the defense has been sluggish, keeps it out of the net this time. But 4-1, you got a lot of shoring up to do.
It was a great block from Taco to keep that one clear, but 13 seed Drexel kind of shocking everybody a little bit here. Coming out playing some solid aggressive offense, and I think we already know what the problem is. Mild drives off the line, doesn't jump for the challenge, and Unchained tips his cap as he goes over his head.
and Unchained just comes through and just disrespects the defense there as he sees that Miles came out a little bit, but he didn't even react to the play, and Drexel all of a sudden, 4-goal lead, a 5-1 scoreline with less than 2 minutes left to play.
A little tip of the cap, Chiefs. Good day, sir.
Good day.
5-1 Drexel, firing on all cylinders.
And the Dragons rolling here in game number one. They might put in six, as that one is off the mark. But I mean, currently it feels like the weakest part for Drexel is, one, the weird hiccups off the back wall, but those get cleaned up easy, right? Or not the cleanups off the back wall, it's the weird rotations in front of the net from Taco has cost them 2 goals. The other big problem that needs to get fixed, though, is the weak back wall defense.
Yeah, and for Maryland, the biggest problem right now is just making sure that your clears are not to a defender, and they're being very, very slow to the ball. You can see in this play alone, twice now this ball comes out to a Drexel player that they're easily able to meet and beat that first defender. The ball goes under Miles here, scapegoat trying to drop it down. Damon finally gets a clear, but so weak, straight to Unchained trying to force the play. Taco able to pick it up and get out for Maryland.
Scapegoat with a little room to work with, throws it right back into that corner. And it really is just clock control currently for the Dragons. They don't really have to stretch too hard. So they're more content to just take whatever the Terps give them here as this game winds down. But my goodness, how's that for game number one? You're like, well, you had a short run through the qualifiers, but your only losses were to the 1 and 2 teams in that qualifier. Then you come out here, put up a 5-1 in game one on the 4 seed. They will get one back here off a nice touch from David.
Yeah, it's a great touch here from David, but a big miss clear again from Drexel. It's really both the goals that they've given up. It's been the big miss from Chase on the back wall, and then an easy clear at the top of the box, or in the middle of the box there for Drexel. So really small mistakes on both sides for these teams. It's just Maryland has been more consistent with the mistakes, and Drexel's been there to punish.
I think if you're UMD, you need that goal just to show to yourself, like, okay, like, we can make plays, even if it comes off of mispositioning and mistakes of our opponents. Like, we need to show that we can get on the board at all. The conversation had to be about game two already at the 4-goal mark.
Yeah.
So just having that momentum of any sort is good for this team.
And I actually think I completely agree with you, as we will wind down to the